we will study some special cases of the force application, and the first case is connected motion with a pulley. Here this one body mass m1, other body mass m2, they are connected with a string, and the string is passing over a pulley. The pulley is on a rigid roof, and for the sake of convenience we have assumed that pulley is frictionless here and there is no mass which is to be calculated. Now, will this system remain in equilibrium or will it move? The answer, it depends. If m1 and m2 are different in masses, their forces will be different and the system will move. Suppose they are not equal and m1 is less than m2. That means m2 is greater, m1 is smaller. Both are being pulled by earth by the force. So in which direction this will move? Will it come down or will it go up? Will it come down or will it go up? By our general knowledge, we can say because m2 is larger than m1. Let me write it this way. M2 is larger than m1. If m2 is larger than m1, then this force should be more and it should move in this way. Now, when this happens and it moves, how will be this motion? Will it be an accelerated motion, uniform motion, or some other type of motion? Answer, it will be accelerated motion. In such cases, when the forces are different, there will be a net force and therefore it will be an accelerated motion. Suppose that acceleration is equal to A. Because this is heavier, this force will be larger and this will go down and this will go up. Now it is connected with one string. Therefore, if this acceleration is A, here the upward acceleration will also be A. It cannot be different because this length cannot increase nor decrease. So if it is coming down with acceleration A, it is going up with acceleration A. Now, is this acceleration equal to G? Answer is no. Because when we leave something, an object, without any obstruction, then free fall, it will fall down with acceleration G. But here, there is a restriction. It is pulling it back. Therefore, this may not be equal to G. Maybe, may not be. But we assume that it is not equal to G and it is A. Okay. When it is trying to come down, this is applying force in this direction. And see the string here. If you straight the string this way, here is M2 and here is M1, and what is the direction of force? M2 in this direction against the string here, M2G here, M1G. So there are two forces acting, and because of that there will be tension in the string. So we assume that there will always be tension in such strings. And as we have studied, the tension at every point is always same, and the direction of tension is always inward. So here the tension is in this direction, here the tension is in this direction. Here this is the direction of tension, here this is the direction of tension, T. Okay, so we have to find out how much is the acceleration in terms of m1, m2, and how much is the T in terms of m1, m2. M1, M2 and G, these are the quantities which are known to us, and we have to find out acceleration and we have to find out tension in the string. For that we start our calculation, and here we take a method which we have seen as free body diagram. Free body, take any one body and assume that it is free from the rest of the system. So here I take this one point and I take this one body, free body. If I make it free body here, what are the forces on that point? On that point, there is a force acting downward, that is m2g. There is a force acting upward, that is tension of the string. Okay, these are the two forces acting on it. As a result of the two forces, these two are not equal. What I observe, that this point is coming down, this is falling down with an acceleration a. With an acceleration a, any body which the mass m2 moving with an acceleration a has force is equal to m2a. This is the unbalanced or the net force on this body. That is why it is moving with acceleration a. If I tell you this body has mass m and it is moving with acceleration a, what is the force on it? M into a. This is mass m2, acceleration a. What is the force? M2a. Then from where this m2a has come? Answer, m2g was acting in this direction, t is acting on this direction, and result of the two is m2a. So what is the relation between them? M2g acting in downward direction, t is acting in upward direction, so I minus it, decrease it. This resultant is equal to m2a, and that is why it is moving with acceleration a. Okay, so this is the relation I get here, number one, from the free body diagram. Again, I make a free body diagram here. Here, acceleration is upward in the opposite direction of g. If it is in upward direction, then out of t and m1g, which should be larger? Answer, t should be larger. That is why the body is going up with acceleration. So here, what will be the net force? Answer, the net force will be t minus m1g. And how much is the net force we have calculated? Net force is acceleration into mass, that is m1a. So this is the two equation you should be able to find out. How? Sum up all the forces, actual forces, that will give you the resultant force. This is actual forces, this gives the resultant force. In both the cases, now it's very easy to find out. Just add them up. Add. This is plus t, this is minus t, cancelled. And what we get here by addition? G is common, m1 plus m2. This is equal to, again, this also to be added, a m1. There is something wrong. Yes, t is cancelled. We have added the two. M2 is plus and m1 is minus. So this we will write as m2 minus m1 is equal to, now you add the two, both are positive. So a is common, m1 plus m2. How much is a here? A is equal to m2 minus m1, because m2 is larger than m1. In case m1 would have been larger, then it should have been m1 minus m2, divided by, this will come here as m1 plus m2. This fraction to be multiplied with g. This is acceleration. And now you see minus and this is plus. This is large, this is small. So this is less than 1. If it is less than 1, then acceleration is less than g. Yes, it is less than g here. So we get this expression for acceleration. Then how much should be the tension? To find out the tension, we can use any one of the equations. Let us say this t. T is equal to m1g plus m1a. So from here we take from 2. T is equal to m1g plus a is equal to m1g plus. Put the value of a as this. This is again equal to g multiplied by m2 minus m1 upon m2 plus m1. this. So this is equal to G will also come out. Okay, let us take it out. G out, and here M1 is out, and here it is 1 plus this quantity M2 minus M1 upon M2 plus M1 is equal to G into M1. Here you take, this is 1 upon 1, this is this upon this, take LCM of the 2, that LCM is M2 plus M1, and here it is M2 plus M1 plus M2 minus M1. Okay. So plus M1 minus M1 cancel each other. This is M2 plus M2, 2M2, it comes out. So it is 2M1 M2, M1 M2 multiplied by G to be divided by M1 plus M2, M1 plus M2. This is value of tension. This is the fraction of masses, M1 M2 upon M1 plus M2, and this is acceleration. Here you will find M, M multiplied. Here M is added. So what will be the after cancellation? This will have a dimension of mass, and this is G, mg. Mg is dimension of force, and tension is a force. That's correct. Here, this is dimension of mass, dimension of mass. Cancel, acceleration has dimension of G, that is again acceleration. So this is the value of tension in the string, 2m1 m2 upon m1 plus m2. If we change m1 and m2, does not make any difference. And this is acceleration, m2 minus m1, heavier minus lighter one. So this is how we solve one type of connected motion, that is motion with a pulley, and we have taken help of free body diagram. This is our free body diagram. Once we make a free body diagram at this point, and once we make free body diagram at this point, so we don't have to combine them. We got everything what we wanted.